Let it rain. Let it rain. Open the floodgates of heaven. Let it rain. Let it. Sing out. Let it rain. Let it rain.
Thank you, Lord. Praise God. Hallelujah. Praise God. Amen. Praise God. Hallelujah. Praise God. Amen. We bless the name of the Lord Jesus Christ for another day to bring forth the word of God through the Open Heaven Devotional written by our Father and the Lord, Pastor E.A. Adeboye. Today is 20th day of December 2020, the day of the Lord for beauty, for glory, and for fulfillment. Your life will never remain the same as you listen and be blessed in Jesus' name. Today's topic is truth and wisdom. Truth and wisdom. And our memory verse is taken from Proverbs chapter 24, verse 24. Proverbs chapter 24, verse 24. He that saith unto the wicked, thou art righteous, him shall the people curse, nations shall abhor him. Again, he that saith unto the wicked, thou art righteous, him shall the people curse, nations shall abhor him. And our Bible passage from that same Proverbs chapter 24, from verse 23. Proverbs chapter 24, verse 23 to 26. He said, these things also belong to the wise. It is not good to have respect of persons in judgment. He that saith unto the wicked, thou art righteous, him shall the people curse, nations shall abhor him. But to them that rebuke him shall be delight, and a good blessing shall come upon them. Every man shall kiss his lips that giveth a right answer. Every man shall kiss his lips that giveth a right answer. Truth and wisdom. Truth and wisdom. May the Lord speak to every one of us in the name of Jesus. May we have encounter with the truth and the wisdom of Jesus today in the name of Jesus Christ. Our friend Lord says this morning, many times we pastors find ourselves in situations where we are faced with either speaking the truth or telling a lie to flatter someone who is influential or from whom we can get a lot of benefits. We are found in this kind of situation and we have the option to speak the truth or to tell a lie. At such times, we must ensure that we do not lie. We must ensure that we do not lie, we do not flatter, we do not exaggerate. We must tell the truth as it is by the wisdom of God given to us. Our God has never been in support of respecting people to the extent of endorsing their wrongdoings. No. God does not give us. We are born of God, born of truth, born of grace, and we must express truth. We must express grace even to the hearers. So, it does not matter who the fellow is or how much you can gain from them. Never lie to get their favor. Never lie to get their favor. Many a times we look at faces of men and because of that, we don't seem to be telling the whole truth or we speak half truth. But Jesus does not endorse that. We must tell the truth at all times, irrespective of the person that we are dealing with. When God told prophet Jeremiah that he would be sending him to nations, he knew what that meant, that he would be confronting some really, really influential people. So he responded in Jeremiah chapter 1, verse 6. What does he say? He said, ha, Lord, God, behold, I cannot speak, I'm a child. Behold, I cannot speak, I'm a child. Many a times we are faced with people of influence, people of, you know, of timber and caliber. We might want to get into that temptation to, you know, exaggerate, to flatter, or even to tell a lie. God does not approve that. He does not say that. So we need the wisdom of God to handle such kind of situation. And God reassured him in Jeremiah 1:7-8, says, "And whatsoever I command thee, thou shalt speak. Be not afraid of their faces, for I am with thee to deliver thee, says the Lord." That was the comforting word that God gave unto Jeremiah that day when he was afraid. He said it. He said, "I am afraid, I cannot speak to them." And God said, "Don't be afraid, I am with you. Don't look at their faces. I'm the one sending you." And the Lord will help us with boldness, with confidence, to speak the truth at all times in the name of Jesus Christ. God will not back anyone that is telling lies in his name just to gain favor of men. God will not back such a person. And we cannot afford to lose the backing of the Lord, the support of the Lord, irrespective of what we do and whoever we are speaking unto. This message is relevant today to every one of us, especially preachers, especially pastors, leaders in the church. Fear not, God is with you to deliver you. Yes, the elders have a saying that it is not the one who we are sent to that we must fear, but the one who sent us. It is not the one that we are sent to. We are sent to men. We are sent to nations. We must not be afraid of them, because God that is mightier than the mightiest, that is higher than the highest, is the one backing us up and is the one that has sent us on this assignment. The Lord will help us to speak the truth at all times and gain wisdom in every situation in the name of the Lord Jesus Christ. So when God has sent you to correct an influential person, you need to do it with wisdom. Yes. John the Baptist confronted Herod and lost his head. But Nathan confronted David and the king repented. What is the difference between the way the two prophets carried out their assignments? John the Baptist was straight and direct with Herod. The Bible says in Mark 6:18, "For John had said unto Herod, it is not lawful for thee to have thy brother's wife." He said it straight. "It is not lawful for thee to have thy brother's wife." Nathan, in his own case, decided to tell the king a fictional story about someone else who did something similar to what David had done. So he got David to judge the case by himself. And when David acknowledged the fellow's sin, Nathan turned it around and said, "Sir, that fellow is actually you." Thereafter, he went on to deliver the message of God that he has sent to him to deliver to him. He was full of wisdom. He gave a fictional story of a similar thing, and David was quick to put down the judgment. And he said to him, "Sir, you are the one that the Lord is sending me to, because you have done evil in the sight of the Lord." So if Nathan had come straight to tell the king that the word will never depart from that sword will never depart from his house, that might be a problem to him. That God has even raised his own family member to go against him and so on, that would be a problem to him. He may have lost his head also. So when God gives us message to deliver to the influential, to give to the people of honor, people that we know, naturally they will not receive the word. We need wisdom to pass across the truth to them. Not necessarily to condemn them, not necessarily to bring them down, but to bring them to the way of repentance and to rededicate their lives and to genuinely seek the Lord's mercy. That is the purpose of the true gospel. Not to condemn, but to bring men back to repentance and to learn the way of the Lord in a better way. And the Lord will give us wisdom in the name of Jesus Christ. Unfortunately, John the Baptist, though the Bible says he was the greatest man that ever lived, apart from Jesus Christ, could not deliver the message with wisdom, and he lost his head. The Lord will give us boldness. The Lord will give us understanding. You can check the book of Acts of Apostles. You can check the book of Acts of Apostles, and you will discover that Peter, Paul, all of them, God gave them wisdom to answer per time. Though they were into one or two troubles with the leaders and the rulers of the day, but God gave them wisdom. And at the end of the day, they were able to spread the gospel with life not in their grave. Praise the Lord. So the Lord Almighty God has given every one of us wisdom to handle the word of God. We should seek for more wisdom so that we'll be able to speak the word of life, the word of truth unto the hearers. And the Lord will help us in the name of the Lord Jesus Christ. The key point for today's devotional is make sure you deliver the message that God has sent to you with wisdom, but ask him for the wisdom with which to present it. Let me take it again. Make sure you deliver the message that God has sent you, but ask him for the wisdom with which to present it. Ask him for the wisdom with which to present it. And the Lord will give us wisdom in the name of the Lord Jesus Christ. Memory verse is Proverbs chapter 24, verse 24. Proverbs chapter 24, verse 24. He that saith unto the wicked, thou art righteous, him shall the people curse, even nations shall abhor him. Nations shall abhor him. The Lord will help us in the name of Jesus Christ with wisdom, with confidence, with boldness to declare the truth, and yet with the wisdom of God to stand for Jesus. And the Lord bless us in Jesus' name. The hymn for today is hymn 26. Stand up for Jesus Christ. And as we stand for Jesus, the truth and the wisdom will uphold us, that anywhere we go, we will not look at the faces of men. We will declare the word of God, and the Lord will bless us in Jesus' name. God bless you. Shall we please pray? Father, we bless your holy name. Lord, we give you praise. Thank you because you are a faithful God. Please help us to find wisdom in you and to be able to speak the truth wherever we go in the name of Jesus Christ. Whoever we have opportunity to speak the word of life to, give us wisdom, knowledge, and understanding to pass the message across even after the order of Nathan. And the Lord bless every one of us as we follow up with whoever that God has sent us to in Jesus' name. In Jesus' name, we are prayed. Amen. God bless you. May the word of the Lord be enlarging your heart in Jesus' name. If you are not born again, please give your life to Jesus Christ today, and your life will never remain the same. In Jesus' name, amen. God bless you. Amen.
Stand up for Jesus. He's soldiers of the cross. Lift high his royal banner in the spots of the loss. From victory unto victory, his army shall be lead, till every foe is
let it rain.